The most versatile tool in your shop is the table saw, right? But maybe not anymore. These days, there are affordable CNC machines for the home shop. I've recently finished setting mine up and making some parts. Stick around to check it all out. I purchased this Work Bee 40x40 from makerparts.ca. It's got a rigid aluminum C-frame, it is screw-driven, and uses NEMA 23 stepper motors. This comes as a kit and takes about 6 or 7 hours of assembly, and there are some pretty good videos available for that. Now, I did opt for the Spark Concept CNC X-Pro V5 controller. It took me a little bit longer to get it set up, but it is working really well. As much as I like using 3D printers, they don't really work well on a large scale, and wood is much more cost effective and fast to produce on a machine like this one. I've been meaning to make some new push sticks for my saw, and these are must-haves to keep your fingers on your hands where they belong. I've designed this one to keep my hands back further away from the blade by adding a little bit longer heel. It also has a long contact area with sandpaper attached to it so it doesn't slip on the wood. I have a full thickness version, and for thinner cuts, I've designed this one. I've machined in recesses for 1/2" by 3/16" magnets, and this way they'll always be within reach and they don't take up space on the top of the saw. This machine does not have an automated tool changer, so when I program with Fusion 360, it creates a separate program for each tool. For the second program, the X and Y axes remain unchanged, and the Z will be probed again to adjust for the height of the new tool to complete the part. As you can tell, I'm in desperate need of dust collection, and I wanted to make my own. I would prefer to have a fixed height design, but those are a bit more complicated, so just to get me going, I've made this one which mounts easily to the Makita Compact router spindle with a hose clamp. It has the typical magnet design, which allows for easy access for tool changes. The first prototype that I made uses 3x10mm magnets, and these are a little bit too small. The modified design, which I'll link below, includes 4x6 magnets. This design also has magnets protruding by 2mm, and that way any side force will not be able to knock the shroud off. This design is based off of many others that I've seen, and it does allow the front skirt to be attached while the program is running. And these are some new push sticks that I've also designed, which include magnets. They also keep your hands further away. They have a really nice grip for your hands to stay where they're supposed to be as well. And a CNC is no good without a nice table or cart. This one is made from 2x4s, which were dried, jointed, and planed. It is on casters, which isn't really a good idea because any variation in the floor will transfer to your CNC machine, but I have a very small shop and I need to be able to move it around. I still need to add a drawer, and I still need to add a tray as well to keep the laptop on the cart at the right height. I still have a lot to learn about programming Fusion 360 for this CNC machine. If you do have any questions, please let me know in the comments. If you have ideas for a better dust collection system, I'd like to hear from you as well. As always, all the parts required to build your own push sticks or dust collection skirt are listed in the comments section below and also available for free on Thingiverse. I hope you enjoyed this shop update video. Take care, everybody. We'll see you on the next one.